In a bid to counter the rampant illegal sex determination tests being conducted in the state of Karnataka, the state government is now mulling over the option of conducting sting operations on doctors across Karnataka who hold illegal sex determination tests in their clinics and hospitals. The health department in Karnataka wants to do this with the help of media houses to expose radiologists and gynaecologists breaking the law.
To prevent this, we have asked the cooperation of the media to constitute a decoy operation panel, from wherein the media will organize the decoy operation and arrange to conduct a raid on a scanning center where sex determination is being carried out. So the department is promoting this by asking the media to arrange for the raid, and in turn the department will provide 50,000 rupees for each raid, successful raid that is conducted in cooperation with the local health department.
However, the medical fraternity in the state is divided in opinion over this decision. They believe that doctors will now think twice before treating patients.
Out with to offer media houses 50,000 for, you know, deploying women in radiology centers to try and carry out sting operations. How effective do you think it would be, you know, as possibly someone who works closely with these, and how effective do you think it would be?
I welcome this, actually suggestion from the government of Karnataka. I welcome this move, but only thing is, how effective is the question? It may be difficult for them to implement, because it will be a little scare. See, doctors, we should be work in a very free environment. Somebody says, somebody X may come, somebody may watching, somebody is going to police you. It may be difficult, but what I request from the government of Karnataka is, let them send a circular, some kind of a guidelines, where what we should follow, how to suspect somebody, or do we have authority to ask somebody, do you have somebody is coming with a pregnant lady, normally we don't take their signature. Now onwards, can we ask them, can we question them, do you really relative? If this is permission is given to a doctor, I think I am very open to this.
Neha Habale is live with us to talk more about this issue. Neha, this is a serious issue because sex determination is illegal in this country, and Karnataka government has now come up with this new policy to crack down on those gynecologists and radiologists. But there should have been some discretion maintained. The moment you give out, you know, the information in this manner that we are going to conduct sting operation, obviously that sets an alarm, isn't it? Why would now, at least for some time, doctors indulge in such practices?
Rightly said, Afrida, of course, why would doctors indulge in practices like these? That is something that's being questioned. And another aspect to this is the fact that the same initiative, a similar initiative, was actually experimented with in 2016, where the doctors had actually put out a commercial in the paper for women volunteers to come forth and to, you know, help the department. But till date, 3 years later, we still stand here in Karnataka, and not one woman has really volunteered, is what we're given to understand. But having said that, I mean, the move, of course, the initiative is welcome, is what a lot of doctors have said. But what really has to be looked at is the implementation aspect of this. Now, how does the health department plan to carry out these sting operations with the help of media houses? And secondly, another important aspect is, Afrida, if I can actually take you back to about a month ago, where a case was reported from Vijaypura in Karnataka itself, where four journalists were sort of blackmailing a sting, or were sort of blackmailing a radiology center. And this is something that was brought to light, of course, and it was only later that the doctors were arrested. But this is another aspect of this. Now, what is the guarantee that, you know, this entire scheme is not misused? What is the guarantee that this initiative is not misused by, of course, anybody who could possibly pose as a journalist as well? Now, that's the second aspect. Mm-hmm. And thirdly, of course, like you rightly pointed out, now we're given to understand that these radiology centers, of course, these clinics as well, gynecologists, would possibly be a little bit more vigil, would be a little bit more aware. Yes. And this would probably ensure that, you know, they do not indulge in this practice of sex determination, or for at least the next couple of months.
Right, because again, it's very tricky. Even the media, of course, is the watchdog, and it does its job with due diligence. There's no need to announce an amount of money. That again makes it extremely unethical to actually pay media houses to do a job like this. Thanks for joining us, Neha.